Hey, are you having trouble trying to learn algebra with notation? Are you not able to sleep at night because you just cannot complete that algebra you started learning from last week? And do you seriously think that hieroglyphics are easier to learn than notation? Then you have came to the right place, since everything is going to look really simple after this. Hey guys, it's EpicHuber Andrew over here, and welcome to my channel. And I do a bunch of Rubik related content, so definitely check it out if you're curious. And back to notation. So, first of all, something to clarify. On one side, there's like notation that the WCA accepts. That's like the official notation. So, for example, R, RW, and 2R. That's kind of like the official notation. And there's also like unofficial notation that's really popular. For example, lowercase r and m. So when you're getting your cube, there's six sides: front, back, up, down, left, and right. And when you take only the first letter, you get f, b, u, d, l, and r. And those six sides, you turn it clockwise, okay? So you might be a little bit confused, like, you know, I know F is like this, right? But is B like this way or this way? Like, seriously, like, I'm not even sure. So how you know that is you take a clock and you hammer it onto your cube. No, actually don't do that. But what you can do is you're gonna think about it as if there was a clock on it, and the clock needs to go clockwise. So now you might be wondering too, so like, I know how to do all the layers. I know how to turn U, R, L, like, and so on, but how to do like U counterclockwise, or if you had to do two U's in a row, is there like a shorter way to do that? And yes, there are. So if you wanted to turn it counterclockwise, you add a prime. So U prime, for example, and you can add prime behind anything and it will become counterclockwise. And you can also add 2 behind it, so times 2 almost. So U2 would mean that you're gonna turn U twice. You could technically stack them together, like U2 prime, but like technically U2 prime equals U2, and the WC doesn't really recognize that, so just stick to U2. So now you know how to do like U, U prime, U2, all the fancy moves. However, how do you turn a cube? So there's like 3 moves that can turn a cube. So it's X, Y, and Z. And it might sound kind of familiar if you have ever touched like any 3D software or seen like a graph with math, okay? And essentially what X means is you turn the whole cube like R. So turn it like R, or you can also call it a little r with a bracket, okay? It's the same, and the WC also recognize both. And for Y, you turn the whole cube like U, okay? And again, U with a bracket around it, remember lowercase u, is also right. And you also have Z, where you turn the whole cube like F. And again, lowercase f with bracket is exactly the same. If you memorize everything up to this point, you should be good for 2x2 and some parts of 3x3. However, for 3x3, you also need to know this, okay? So you need to know what lowercase f, lowercase b, lowercase u, lowercase d, lowercase l, lowercase r, are. So what they mean is actually pretty similar to, you know, their capitalized counterparts, okay? So f means like this. You can see you turn also the middle layer, so you turn 2 layers. And same as b, so you do b, almost the same as capitalized b, but you also turn the middle layer, so 2 layers at a time. And everything else is exactly the same, so u, d, l, and r. However, this isn't official. So the actual official notation is fw for lowercase f, bw for lowercase b. And actually the w means wide, so wide moves, you can see, and uw for u, and so on, okay? So now you know how to turn the layers clockwise, counterclockwise, you know, 2 layers at a time, really fancy stuff. But there's also a problem, like how do you only turn one like middle layer at a time? So actually there's notation for this. There's M, where you turn the middle layer like L, there's S, that you turn the middle layer like D, and there's E, that you turn the middle layer like F. So the WC actually doesn't recognize like M, S, or E, and there's no alternative WC like notation for it. So technically, there isn't M moves. So now let's move on to 4x4. So for 4x4, you obviously need to know how to do two layers at a time. And now the website will, instead of using like the lowercase letters, they will start to use like the actual official notation like FW, BW, UW, and DW, and so on and so on. Okay, so if you've made it this far, I really congratulate you for your effort, okay? Applause. Well, anyways, we're gonna move on to 5x5 and above. And now you might see something like 3RW, 4RW, or like even bigger numbers. And what that actually means is the number before is the layers are gonna count from the most outside, and you count to 1, 2, 3, and that's 3RW, those three layers, and you turn it, there you go, 3RW. 4RW is the same, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4RW, there you go. And so on and so on, okay? So everything else still applies, so you still can have 2 and prime, okay, behind the notation that can modify it. And here's something also new. So you might have seen something like 3F, 3R. So what does that mean, actually? So what it means is really similar to what we just said. However, you only turn one layer, okay? So 3R means you count from the most right side, and you count 1, 2, 3, and you move that specific layer. So you move it upwards, okay? Only that layer, okay? However, it's really rare that like you will actually only move that layer. Like, it's generally you would do like RW prime and you would do 3RW. Like, it's easier to do it on a bigger cube. Anyways, that pretty much sums up all the notation that you need to know for a regular Rubik's cube. And I just made a Google Sheet document, and it's at the description below, so definitely check it out. And if you hated this video, I guess dislike.
Why are we still here? Just to suffer.
Well, if you liked this video, hit the like button, and even consider subscribing and share to your friend that you think needs to know this video. And anyways, this is the Epic Cuber. Bye, guys.